This is brought to you by BNK Wines, great wines in the Kingdom of Thailand. Welcome back, everyone. We are talking about rooftops right here in the City of Angels in Bangkok. And here's the man of the house here, my friend Nicholas, the GM of the Hotel News. How are you doing, my friend?
I'm good, Daniel. Thank you.
All right. We are giving out awards this week and in the weeks to come. And of course, we decided to give the best rooftop venues to the speakeasy at the Hotel News. So congratulations.
Thank you very much. We're delighted. That's it's great news. And obviously, I guess it's a lovely New Year present for us. I think it just capped off a fantastic 2013.
It's been really good for you guys, huh?
It's been great. The Muse has been doing extremely well. And then Speakeasy has just been, you know, sort of rocking, really. So that's very, very good. It's lovely.
All right. So we're going to talk about cocktails. What does, in the atmosphere at Speakeasy, what does it make stand out so brilliantly?
I think, you know, so many rooftop bars in Bangkok, this is a great city for that. We just have to try to be different. So it's definitely different in terms of the concept, the interior design, 1920, 1930, Great Gatsby. And for the cocktail, we just try to go back to that era as well. So we have a lot of, quite a few, what we call forgotten vintage cocktails. I mean, I'm talking French
like
Martini, I'm talking sort of Aviator, cocktails that you don't see on the map anymore. But we also do the great classic, the mojito, we do, you know, the Mai Tai, but we try to do them with a twist, with an ingredient that are carefully selected and people just don't use. Like mojito, we do that with palm sugar, you know, rather than just brown sugar or normal sugar. Sort of the Mai Tai, you know, quite of a some, you know, age Angostura bitter, so try just to find a twist to make this cocktail different from the others, sort of.
So details and quality.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the same. We try to have quite a very good selection of whiskey. We're talking like, you know, what I call a vertical, different brand, different, you know, vintages, you know, from, you know, Macallan, 25 years, 12 years, 8 years, you know, and so on. So I think people come here because they know it's going to be good, and it's going to be fun, the award, I think, just kind of summarized all of it.
Great. We're going to talk very briefly about the menu. You do have a menu, and there's something new about it.
We have a new menu, and I think Speakeasy has been very successful from day one, still very successful, and it's great. But it has been successful for the location, the theme, and the drinks, not so much for the food. So we looked at that last year, and sort of got to work together with a French Michelin star chef, great guy called Jean-Baptiste Nathalie, or JB.
That you have seen on a previous episode.
And JB just created a menu for us. And he found the inspiration from dishes or flavors that he remembered from his childhood. Again, we're going back to that vintage theme, 1920, 1930, 1940. So these are dishes that, you know, sort of, again, not done anywhere else in Bangkok. And JB's been traveling through Asia for about just under 10 years now. So he's been able just to mix his French influence with the local ingredient. And I think the result is something staggering. I mean, it's beautiful food, food to share around the table with a nice cocktail or a nice glass of wine.
Sounds very Asian.
Yeah,
and
yummy.
Yummy. And I'm going to be so lucky that I'm going to actually try to get one of these dishes in my belly, and I'm so hungry. But what I'm going to do also, I'm going to talk to the executive chef, I believe.
Correct, because we have someone here that does our Thai food, and obviously he's in charge of doing JB's food on a daily basis. This is Chef King, our executive chef.
All right, well, thank you very much for stopping by. We're gonna let the GM go. We're gonna go for a short break. Just sit back, relax, don't do anything. We'll be right back. I'm Daniel, and you're watching My Second Home. All right, we are back, and we are still, of course, at the Hotel Muse. I am going to do the most pleasant thing. I'm gonna try the dishes pretty soon. But sitting next to me is the executive chef of the Hotel Muse, and right here at the Speakeasy, Kung King. How are you?
Very good, thank you. And you?
Very good. I'm very happy to see so beautiful food. Okay. So tell us, you are the executive chef here at the Hotel Muse.
Yes.
How long have you been a chef?
How long is my experience? Is almost 30 years.
Wow.
And I just come back from England. I work in Southampton in hotel, executive chef too.
Wow.
And I try to find job when I come back in Thailand, and I have good job in this hotel.
Great.
Hotel.
Yeah. And so we're gonna talk a little bit about the menu here. It's a collaboration, from what I understand, with Jean-Baptiste Nathalie.
Yep.
From France, and let's try and describe what we have here.
Yeah, this one is we call marinated white prawn served with apple jelly, but it's the flavor of a little bit Asia with jasmine flower.
Wow.
That is played with a lot of people just love it.
Yeah?
Yeah, because it's something amazing about it, the herb and the jelly apple. And the fresh prawn we order from Andaman Ocean,
Right. So the best of the best, I guess, huh?
Yeah.
And the next dish is?
Yeah, that one is really nice too. We call it marinate the cream and herb with the fresh salmon. This is the best salmon because it's really, really difficult to make it because we marinate them for one day.
Wow.
Become it only dip. And we serve on the top with the fresh garden salad with the balsamic cream.
Oh, a balsamic cream. Yeah. Wow, that
sounds... When you eat them inside the salmon, you can feel the cream and the herb.
Great. It sounds like all these different tastes put together.
Exactly.
So it's like French, but a lot of Asian in it too.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Any other favorite in the menu that you have?
It's a lot.
A lot? Mention one more.
For the main dish, I think it's a Wagyu. Wagyu beef is amazing because the chef JB, he have like something to present it about the beef put in the bread and put in the oven. Normally the Wagyu beef is steak, right? You can see the product is Wagyu steak, but JB try to put the beef Wagyu in the bread and put it in the oven.
Wow.
But like something, what inside, where the beef, you know, but actually in the bread.
It's in the bread, almost like a tiny Wellington.
Yeah, something like that.
Something like that. Well, thank you very much for stopping by.
You're welcome, sir.
And be sure to come and check out this fabulous menu right here at the Speakeasy on the rooftop of the Hotel Muse on Soi Lang Suan right here in Bangkok. I'm going to say thank you to Kung King. And we're going to move down. We're going to give out the award, and we do what we do best, eat and drink. So don't go away. All that when My Second Home with Daniel returns.